So on create public demand, today we are going to install Tails. As we saw in the previous lecture, Tails is best for surfing the dark web. It's totally secured, and plus you don't have to do any security settings on the Tor browser, which we did in the installing Tor lecture. Plus, the Tails also come with all the software is required for visiting or working on the dark web, that is the VPN, the Tor, and several other tools. In this lecture, we are going to download, install, configure, run the Tails. So let's get started. First of all, you need a 8 GB USB drive. You can install Tails on your computer also, you can put it on your desktop, but we are installing it in our USB drive because of security reasons, as discussed in the earlier lectures. Also, you can protect yourself from threats. We will see in the danger section of this lecture, of this course, sorry. So if you are attacked while you are using Tails, you are using Tails and you have a Trojan or something, so you are basically attacked by hackers, you can just remove your hard drive, not your hard drive, your pen drive or anything like that, and you are totally safe, right? So 8 GB pen drive is required for installing and using Tails. A pen drive or a hard disk or a CD-ROM is also okay. Less than 8 GB is not available, not suitable for installing and using Tails. So I have a pen drive. You can see USB drive I have, that is totally empty. You'll have to format your 8 GB drives. 8 GB or more than that doesn't matter, but you'll have to format your 8 GB drives because whenever you are booting a drive with another OS, it's going to be formatted by default, so nothing matters. For downloading Tails, you have to just go to your favorite browser. In this case, it's Chrome. You'll just have to write Tails. Here it is. Go to the first website, that's tails.bom.org. Scroll down. You can read the stuff. It's kind of interesting. Nothing in there. So scroll down. See free software. You can download Tails for free and independently get Tails 4.14. So here are the options on Windows, Mac OS, Linux. Currently, we are installing it on the USB drive, so we'll be clicking on four USB sticks, USB image, click on that, download Tails, verify your download. Okay, so if you read on this website, tails.borum, which is the official website of Tails, you'll see that it requires two websites to configure and install Tails. But it's not like that. You can also use one website, only one pen drive. Sorry if I was saying pen drive before, sorry, website before. But you by default only require one pen drive, and in this video also we are going to use only one pen drive for installing Tails. The second pen drive, which the Tails website recommends, is for storing capacity, because as discussed earlier, whenever you remove your pen drive containing Tails OS, it will delete all the files you have created previously, right? So it will be like a factory data reset in your phone. Whenever you'll open again, you'll open Tails again, it would be empty, right? So it doesn't matter. For downloading Tails, just click on download Tails 4.14 USB image. It's 1.1 GB file. Click on it, and sometime it will be started developing, downloading. All right, so I have downloaded it, so I'm just canceling it. For booting your pen drive with this Tails image.image file, you'll have to download another software, that is RUFUS, Rufus. All right, click on just search Rufus, right? On the first result, that is Rufus official website, click on that. You see Rufus drive properties and things like that. We'll see this later. Just download this software now. So you'll see Rufus 3.13. At current time when I'm recording this video, the latest version is 3.13. On whenever you are downloading, there may be some another higher version than this. You feel free to download that. There's nothing, I don't think there will be any changes in the installation procedure. So click on it just, and we'll start developing, downloading. I'll just click cancel because I have also downloaded that. When you have downloaded your Tails disk file .iso or .img file, you'll have to verify your download because sometimes, or not majority of the times, there are chances that you have downloaded some corrupted version. So it's better to verify that. See, I have downloaded Tails AMD64. I'll just click on it and the website will verify it if it's corrupted or it's a copy or something. So better safe than sorry. It's being verified. After verification, we'll boot the Tails into our pen drive, right? So again, I'll show you my pen drive. This is the USB drive in which I am going to install Tails. It's showing 7.24 GB left, but it's like 7.8 GB. 500 MB is emergency storage or something, they tell it. But the main, you know, the main memory of the pen drive is 7.8 GB. Verifying Tails again, it can take 2 to 5 minutes, doesn't matter. But it's very important part, don't ever skip this verification part. See, verification is successful. For security, always verify a download. Yes, so you can see here I have downloaded Rufus and Tails. So you don't need to have installed this Rufus. Just click on the file which you have installed. It will not start up an installation wizard. It will just start the software. It's a simple software, so it doesn't matter. Yes, okay, this is it. See, no label devices, you have to select that properly because no label F drive 7.8 GB. You can see SanDisk Cursor Braid is also showing the official name, but select your device very carefully because in that device, when your OS will be installed, that is here in the case OS is Tails, the device will be totally formatted, right? So select, it will just take 2 to 3 minutes to, you know, just verify your device, because if you choose the wrong device, there may be a situation in which your whole computer is formatted, right? So boot selection, select your .img file from where you have downloaded Tails. This file I have to select, and don't do anything with, you know, any of the, you know, advanced web properties. No settings are needed to be changed. Just click on start. Warning, all data on the device, again as I said earlier, will be destroyed. To continue this operation, click OK. To quit, click cancel. If you have not deleted your data, click on cancel and format it or have your backup, right? Okay, so the drive will be formatted and it's currently booting it. It will take 2 to 3 minutes, depends on your computer speed, but after it's ready, your Tails is ready to be run. As you know, after the installation of Tails, we are not going to use the Tails through, you know, Windows. Windows will not be running. Why will not be running while we are using Tails? So we'll have to shut down the computer, go into the BIOS, or we can say boot menu, and then afterwards we'll have to select our pen drive name. In this case, it's SanDisk. So from there, your device will be booted, your Tails will be booted, and then you can access, you know, Tails. That's a great factor because the Windows is not running. In this case, Windows, in your case it can be Mac or Linux, is not running in the background, and thus it cannot leak your data, you know. So let it write this image, or it's just booting the drive. So it will take 2 to 3 minutes, but it's worth it, right? Okay, so as you can see, Rufus has completed booting a pen drive. Don't click on start, right? Don't click on start, click on close. Your device has been booted, and after booting, you cannot see your device in your PC. You can see I'm clicking on this PC, I cannot see any external drive edit here because it's a bootable pen drive. Now it's not a normal pen drive where you can see your folders and things like that. If there will be a problem afterwards when you want to convert your bootable pen drive into normal pen drive, which will show here, and you can put your files in there. It's not like that. I'll show you, or I'll just link a YouTube video in the resources section where you can, you know, format the drive without accessing it from here, right? So just click close. So now I have my pen drive is totally booted with Tails. I have my Tails OS ready, but now I'll have to, you know, shut down the PC and open the boot menu. This is an HP PC, so the key for opening the boot menu is F9. It can be different depending on your PC model, but yes. So I'll shift to external camera now, because, you know, boot menu cannot be screen recorded. But we'll see Tails installation we have seen. We'll see Tails configuration. There's not much configuration, but yes, we'll see that. We'll also see the features given to us by Tails. So let's shift to the external camera. Hey guys, sorry, I have to cut this video short because it exceeds the video size of Udemy. But no worries, in the next lecture you will see the screen recording of my, you know, Tails starting and stuff like that, where I will be restarting my computer, opening the BIOS settings, and booting into Tails, and using some functions of the Tails, basic configurations of the Tails. Nothing much. Thank you very much. In the next lecture you will see these things. Sorry, I was thinking of including these things into this lecture, but this video was going too long, and also in the size it was quite big, and Udemy didn't give an error. Udemy actually gave an error that you cannot upload videos of this much size, so I'll have to cut it in half. But no worries, in the next lecture we'll see each other. Thank you.